are going to go ahead and work on our Eiffel Tower in this segment. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to cover the canvas completely with our background color. So in order to do that, I want to go ahead and I'm going to mix a green. So I'm going to, it's like a turquoisey green. So I'm going to use my blue and I'm going to use my yellow. And I want it to be more blue than yellow because I do want it to be that turquoisey color, which has more blue to it. So first, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to mix that color. I want to make sure that I mix a fair amount because we are covering the entire background. But as we're covering that background, I want you guys to think about how much paint you're using. We want it to dry relatively quickly, and we don't want there to be a lot of bumps. So we want to make sure that that paint is spread out really, really nice and smooth. So that way it dries quickly and it's a smooth surface that we're going to draw on. This is going to take some time. We do want to have some patience, and you do want to take a break if you get tired at some point, because this one is going to take a little bit more time. So what I'm going to do is I'm starting with a color that I like, and then I'm adding some white right to it to lighten it. I don't want it too dark. Even add a little bit more here. And like I said, I want to make sure that I mix a fair amount so that I can cover my whole canvas without having to remix colors. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm not going to worry if there's like streaks of color in here. I actually like if there's streaks of color in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go straight up and down. I'm pressing down pretty hard with my brush, and as I go through here and as I'm adding this paint here, I'm going to go through and even add some white so I can get some streaks through here. And you don't have to do that, it's just what I like to do. As we cover this, we want to make sure that we cover every part of the canvas. We don't want to have lots of skipped spots or anything. That's going to make it look a little bit unfinished. So we want to take our time and really make sure that we've covered it all. Again, I'm going to go through, go right over top. I'm going to blend that white right in to my canvas. And then as I finish up this bottom here, I'm going to be very conscious of where the paint is that's wet so that I don't get a nice big thumbprint in there. I'm just really coating this canvas here. And again, as I go, I can go ahead and add some white for some streaks in here. And I'm just doing straight up and down. Streaks of white. And then to get this last section, I'm just gonna kind of turn it on the side, and I'm kind of balancing it with my thumb and my pinky here. Just gonna hold it very carefully so I don't drop it. I'm going to make sure I'm still going with the same brush stroke, that up and down brush stroke here. And I'm going to add some white, just like that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put this down and we're going to let it dry really, really good. It's just going to take a few minutes. So go ahead and clean out that brush, wipe it on the side of the cup, dry it off, and then we're just going to let it dry really, really good before we go to draw. Okay, so for this painting, we are going to go ahead, and now that this is completely dry, I can look at every angle and I don't see any reflection, so I know that the whole thing is completely dry. So this is one of those things that we are going to want to really try and get our drawing down the best, because that way we're going to feel really solid when we go in to do the painting. So what that means is that, especially on this painting, if you, or on this drawing, if you decide that you're not comfortable with a line or something just doesn't seem to line up right, I want you to take the time to go ahead, pause the video, erase it, you know, try it again, whatever makes it so that in the end you know that you've done your absolute best and then you have something to be very, very proud of. So what I'm going to do to start is just a little kind of, you know, note here is that we've kind of got like a, almost like a worm's eye view where we're going to be, you know, standing at the bottom of the Eiffel Tower looking up. So it's kind of going, you know, straight off into the sky. So what we want to do is we want to start by marking a few points that are going to help us get this on here. So the first point I'm going to mark is I'm going to come up about an inch on the left side. And I'm just going to make myself a little dot right there. And then I'm going to come up on the right hand side here. And I am going to pretend that my canvas is cut in half. And right at the halfway point, I'm going to mark another spot. Then at the top, I'm going to come in and I'm going to say about 3 inches. I'm going to come down just a little bit and I'm going to make one more dot. So I've got a dot here, and a dot all the way down here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by drawing one straight line down. And it's not going to be super long. It's just a straight line down. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw the top. So what that is it's going to be a straight line across. And by straight, I mean relatively straight. And then, so you can see kind of how far it came out, it's about a half inch. Then I'm going to angle down on that side. And I'm going to angle the same angle down on the left side. I'm going to come down at this point, and I'm going to angle in and angle in like that. After that, you come down just a little bit more. I want those angles to be the same. After that, I'm going to draw a straight line across like that. So this, and you still have these angles right here. Once I get those angles down, what I'm going to do is I'm going to carefully connect this dot, or this corner right here, to this dot. Now what I want to think about is I don't want it to be straight. I want it to be curved in just a little bit. So whatever I do to this side for this angle though, I want to do the same to here. We're only going to see the left side over here, and you're only going to see part of the right side over here. So we want to consider that as we're doing things. So what I'm going to do is I am going to come down just a little bit, and then I'm going to curve like that. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same thing, but I want to keep this symmetrical. And then once we get to here, obviously we won't be able to see this side, but we want to keep it, and we're going to keep that curve, and we're going to take it all the way down to here. So if it's easier, which sometimes it is, I'm going to go ahead and I'm doing it upside down. I'm starting light right now so that I can, if I need to erase it, I can. And don't be worried if you need to erase it. Again, take the time. Because you'll be happier in the end. So if I look at this right now, what I'm seeing is I came in too far here. So what I want to do is I'm going to try this again, and I'm going to come out just a little bit more. And that I'm much more pleased with. So I'm going to continue that line down. And then what I can do is I can simply take my eraser and erase that original line. Like that. Just looking at it, I want to see if I want to try a little bit more to come out, because I think that I will feel even better if I come out one more time here. Again, I just erase that line. Now I just want to make this a little bit easier for myself to see. And I think I'm pretty happy with that. So these are the lines that I've got here. And what I'm going to do is I am going to start by coming down just a smidge here. And I'm going to make a straight line across. For me, it's easier to turn my canvas this way and make a straight line. Doesn't mean it'll be easier for you, but you can try it. But I want it to be as straight of a line as possible. And again, we can always erase it if it's crooked, so we don't have to worry. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to extend this just a little bit past our original line. Maybe even a little bit more. And then I'm going to curve it down just a little bit, not all the way to here, but down just a little bit. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do another straight line. So we've got another straight line. Oops, I can tell. I went a little bit too narrow right here, so I'm going to go ahead and take the time to fix that. And then this one extends just a little bit more again, and it does the same thing, and it stops just before here, and then one more straight line. Like that. I think I went too narrow again. Go ahead and erase that. And I want to curve this out just a little bit more. I just kind of curved that little corner right there. And then what I'm going to do is I am going to erase the lines inside. So these two little lines right here. Like that. So now we've got this. Then what I'm going to do is I am going to come down about an inch and a half, let's say. I'm going to do another straight line. There we go. Got another straight line. It stops at the leg though. So I'm not gonna worry about that. Then I'm gonna come, let's see, I'm gonna come just below there. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna make a line right about here. And this is going to be where it curves down and we've got that half circle, but I want to line everything else up, but I don't want to forget this. So that's why I'm kind of giving myself a little reminder line here. So what's going to happen next is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to figure out how wide I want this leg to be. And so I'm going to come in about here, which is a little over an inch, and then come in a little over an inch again. And then I'm going to go from the center point. Well, first of all, actually, I'm going to make one straight line going this way. And then I'm going to go from the center point and I'm going to follow this curve completely until I get to this line. So it's going to get wider as it comes down. It's going to start narrow and get wider as it comes down. So I'm going to go ahead, but I'm following that curve like that. And then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to follow that curve and it's going to meet up together like that. I want to straighten this just a little bit. Like that. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I've got this part right here where it angles and it came down. I'm going to put a straight line so that it stops right about here. So right at the bottom of that rectangle. And then this one is actually going to come down a little bit longer. It's not a straight line, but it comes down a little bit longer on this side. Then what's going to happen is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to come down to about here. I'm going to come about halfway between here and here. It's about where we're going to be. And I'm going to do a straight line. You might notice at this point that we have almost like a letter A. So that kind of gives you an idea. And what's going to happen is it went past each leg on the side, and again, we're going to angle down just like we did up here. And angle down. And again, this side is going to come straight down, and then this side is going to wrap back around like this. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a straight line across. Like that. And then I'm going to come down just a little bit more and make another straight line across. Like that. And then I'm going to have one more straight line. You know what? I'm going to move these lines up just a smidge. Again, it's better to take the time to change something that you're unhappy with. So I'm going to keep my original line, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make this part a little bit thinner, like that. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make the next line, still straight, and then I'm going to make one more thinner bar, and it's going completely across. Right there. So we've got this one. So you've got this first top part, then you've got this part, which you will be able to see these lines here. But then on this one, I'll show you, you're not going to see those lines. So this one is going to be completely solid this way. Then this one, you're going to see these two parts. And then this one, we're also going to erase. The center like that. So this is what you should have so far. Then what we're going to do is we are going to work on getting this leg to continue down. Now again, as we come down, we want this to be narrow up top and then wider as we get down the bottom. So even though this line isn't going to cut through all of here, we want to go ahead and we want to pretend like it's going through here, and then right here it picks back up again. And so it's going to come right to about here. So that's maybe 2 inches that it comes in. But you'll see it's narrow at the top and it comes wider and wider and wider. And that's what you want. I'm going to narrow this side just a smidge. I just realized I need to. Just like that. Okay. So then I've got this corner here, and what I want to do with this corner is right here, I'm going to make this part of the half circle right there. Then remember this line that we started? We're going to go ahead and we're going to follow that band here like that. So we've got that half circle now. Now down here, we are actually going to put another straight line. Whoops, let me do this. Another straight line just about here. It's about an inch from this line. About an inch. Right like that. And then you're going to go ahead, and there's kind of like these half circles. There's like smaller ones, and then a larger one, and then a couple more smaller ones there. So that kind of gives you an idea. And then right in here, so we're in, so here's the top section, here's the middle section, here's the bottom section. So we're gonna go into the middle section. And right here, we're gonna make almost a 7. It's not quite, but it's almost. Just like that. Now everything else we are going to paint. So this is where we should be right about now with our pencil. Everything else we're going to paint. If you decide that you don't want to paint it and you don't want to take the chance and you'd rather draw it out, as I paint it, you'll be able to draw it. That might be better if you're more comfortable doing that, or you can try and paint it. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to start working on the painting. Now that we've got our roadmap kind of figured out here, this is going to be a lot easier as we go. So what we're going to do is we are going to take that smallest brush. It's going to be important that our black paint that we're going to be using the most here is thin enough that we can really just glide along. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to dip my brush in the water, and I'm going to mix some of the water into my paint. Because even if I've just poured the paint, sometimes it's just easier to get it to smooth just a little bit more, and we really, really want this to glide. Now, the trick to adding the water to the paint, though, is not adding so much that all of a sudden everything just drips right off. So you can tell that it's not dripping right off. So I want to be very cautious of that, because if I drip all over this painting, it's going to be a little bit trickier to fix today. So I wanna try really hard not to. So I'm going to do one more, and you're going to be able to tell with your paint if it's smooth enough to use. So I'm really making sure that that water is mixed in. I really don't want to take any chances that it's going to drip on my painting. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to dry it off really good. I don't want any water coming out all of a sudden here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to roll my paintbrush right into that black paint. And I'm going to start right at the top, and I'm just going to start working my way down. Now there's going to be some spots that we're doing with black, some spots that we're doing with gray, and then we're going to do some white highlights. So for the most part, we're just going to work with this black right now, and then we'll fill in those other sections with the gray. So right now what I'm going to do is I am going to, now remember too, the harder that you press with this brush, the wider the line's going to be. So when I go to do these lines in here, I personally want thinner lines, so I'm going to barely press down on my canvas. When you go to do this one, if you want, if you haven't used this brush a lot yet, I would go ahead and I would kind of play around with it on your plate and really get a feel for how wide that line is and see if your paint glides and really kind of work with it before you go onto your canvas. So what we're going to do next is I've got my paint loaded onto my brush, and I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to start with that first line. And I barely pressed down, and that's how wide my line was. So then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start filling in this top part. Now some of these lines are going to have little highlights, and so you kind of want to still keep in mind where those pencil lines are. So sometimes what I like to do is I like to not go all the way up to the pencil line if I know that there's going to be a line there. So I went ahead and I'm just filling this in. I'm not going to scrub with this brush because I don't want to break it. So I'm just very gently letting it glide along. Fill that in here. So again, I know I'm going to have a highlight on this side, so I'm going to give myself just a little bit of a gap here to remind myself that that's where that highlight is going to go. So you can kind of see that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to outline this first rectangle, and I'm barely pressing down. I really want these lines to be nice and thin as I go. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make little bars going across the top. Don't worry with exactly how many you make. The thing that you want to do is you want to try and keep them the same width and the same distance apart from one another. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to trace these main lines. I'm going to really make sure that my hand is as steady as it can be. I'm going to barely press down. And I'm going to follow this line all the way. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do the same thing. Just like that. When I do this side, it's just easier for me when I flip it to get that same angle. So you don't have to flip yours, but it's easier for me when I do. right up to the top, like that. And then I'm going to do the same thing right here. Just like that. Some nice smooth lines. Now this next part, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start outlining this line. I'm not filling this in. So I want you to think about that as we're going. Is we're going to do that line, but we're not filling it in like we did the top one. So I'm barely pressing down, keeping my hand steady by putting it on my canvas. But I want to keep in mind that as I do this, that I'm not sticking my hand in wet paint, which is also why we're kind of working from the top down. That's just going to be helpful as we go. Then I'm going to trace all the way down here and come straight down. So I've got that done. Then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to angle this line down just a little bit to the halfway point, so you can see right there. And then I'm going to go right about here. We didn't draw this line, but that's okay. We're just coming as straight as we can. You see, I'm kind of like sketching it. So this line doesn't need to be a crazy perfect line. Just kind of sketching it. And then what I'm going to do is this line right here. I'm going to go ahead and go over. And then I'm going to close off this side right here. And so right here I'm going to fill this in. Like that. And then this side I'm going to leave open. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come here. I'm going to continue this line down. Oops, I need to add more paint. Like that. And then I'm going to finish this line out. Like that. And then, remember, we've got these two lines here, but it doesn't go all the way through. And then we skip that section, and then we go back through here again. And then we stop when we get to these double bars. And so the same thing over here. We go up, we stop when we get to here. Like that. Then what I'm going to do is I'm kind of looking, and if you look on an angle, you can tell what paint is wet and what paint isn't. And since this area isn't really wet, I'm going to go back up to here. Now again, be careful if you steady your hand. You want to make sure that you're not sticking it in wet paint. And what I want to do here is whatever I do on one side, I'm going to do on the other side. And I want to start with small X's. And by the time I get down here, I want them to be a little bit larger. They don't need to be huge, but we want them to be a little bit larger. So I'll show you what I mean. So I'm going to start by just making a simple X. And if I make an X on that side, I need to make an X on this side. And if you look, you'll see the corners of the X's are going to line up as best as I can. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make a few small ones. And again, all those corners should line up as best as you can. And then as I come down, I'm going to let them get a little bit bigger. So if I get bigger on the right, then I need to get bigger on the left. And they should still be straight across, like I should be able to put a straight line across there. And I don't want them to end huge, so I don't need to get them to go too big too fast. Two more X's if I let them get a little bit bigger. So that's what I'm going to do. One more corner to corner. Like that. We've got those ones done. Then what we're going to do is we're going to skip down to these two lines right here. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to give myself that line, which again, I want to be careful not to press too hard and get too wide of a line. Like that. And then what I'm going to do on the inside here is I'm going to go across like these bars up top. So we're going straight up and down. And again, the most important thing is you want to try and keep them the same width and the same distance apart from each other. So you want to keep the pressure of your brush the same amount as best as you can across the whole thing. Like that. Next part we're going to do is we are going to fill in the X's right here. Now right here also, we're going to have a line that cuts this in half. Now again, we're going to follow the same angle. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm following that angle so it's cutting it in half. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to follow this angle. Just like that. So then what's going to happen is I'm going to, again, whatever I do on one side, I'm going to do on the other. So these are going to be a little bit bigger X's, so we may only be able to fit two here. So one, two, it should cross right at that line. That's the idea. And then we're going to go across here. Go across there. So whatever I did to this side, I'm going to do to this. So I want to look at where they meet up, which is about here. So I want to take my line and crisscross right to there. Go right there. And then again, do a little bit bigger, but I still want to try and get it to crisscross right in the center, like that. Next thing we can do, fill in this section. Here. I'm being very careful, which is why I didn't switch to a different brush. It's a not a super small space, but just want to make sure. That I have as nice of an edge as I can. So I'm going to fill that in right there. And then make sure that's all, no gaps. There we go. And then I'm going to go ahead, turn this to the side, and I'm going to trace this line right here. Straight as I can. And again, keep in mind, as long as you are trying your absolute best, you are going to be super proud of yourself at the end. And go ahead, take this corner out. Set up really bows right there. And then I'm going to just below it. Go across again. So you're just going to follow that line. We don't have this line drawn, and that's okay. But we're just going to follow this line. As straight as we can. I'm barely pressing down. We're going all the way across. Like that. And then we're going to do something similar to the bars here, but we're going to make them a little bit taller and a little bit wider. But the most important thing about this is, again, keeping them spaced as equally as possible and keeping them straight up and down. We don't want them angled here. Reload my brush. Like that. Next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to come back here and I'm going to do this line now. So I'm going to keep it as straight as I can. That was not very straight, so I'm going to re-steady my hand. Down. Curve that line in. Come up this way. Like that. And then for this part, I am going to switch to my medium brush to fill this one in. So I'm just going to load that right there. Very carefully. My medium brush just fits inside there. If yours doesn't, if it's a little thinner or a little thicker, go ahead. Turn that brush the way that you need. Get nice smooth lines there. And I can go ahead and rinse this out for right now. I'm going to be using it again in just a minute here, but keep it nice and clean. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to go right back into my paint with my thin brush, and I'm going to follow these lines. And then, like, this right here. Like that. And I'm gonna come right here. Spin this around. Come as straight as I can across here. Like that. This line. Right here. I'm gonna come back in here. And I'm gonna do where this half circle comes. Like that. And then this band, what we'll do here is we'll take that medium brush again. We're going to come right up to it and do that sideways hold on the brush so it gives us a nice smooth line. And then I can go ahead and pull down that paint so that I can fill this whole area in. And then I'm going to rinse out that brush. Dry it off nice and good. It's ready to go when I need it. And then in this band right here, this rounded area, what we're going to do is we're actually going to be drawing or painting little black rectangles. And again, with this, don't worry too much, but you want to try and keep them the same size. You want to try and space them out about the same amount. So again, if you feel more comfortable drawing this out so that you can give yourself a little bit more of a roadmap, you can absolutely do that. Thank you. like that. Now my brush is getting a bunch of paint in it, and I want to thin out some more of my black paint. So I've got that done. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to rinse out that brush so that I can start with a nice fresh brush again. I'm going to dry it off really good. Again, we don't want any water sneaking away here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come to this side right here, and I'm going to continue this line. Now again, it's going to skip this area, but I want it to come back through here again. So I'm going to roll to make sure all those bristles are nice and stuck together. Again, when I'm doing this angle, I seem to have an easier time this way. So we're cutting this in half again, but we're following the angle that we have. And I'm barely pressing down. Like that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to make two straight lines coming down here. It's going to be one straight line like this, and one straight line like this. And then I'm going to make another straight line across. I'm cutting it right in half. And now you can kind of see those boxes. And in those boxes are going to be X's. So like this box, I can only see part of the X, so I just made that one part. This box, I'm going to be able to see the full X. So it's going to go from corner to corner. And then this box is going to go from corner, not quite to corner, and then corner, almost corner. So you're going to kind of have to gauge where you want it to go, how much of it you're going to see. But corner to corner is really just kind of the rule of thumb here. You got to kind of pretend where your corner is going to be. Okay, the next part, this section right here, is just going to be diagonal lines, equally spaced as best as you can. Like that. And then diagonal lines going the opposite way. It makes a bunch of little X's. Like that. And then right here we're going to imagine this is the square, and we're going to go down with another big X. And again, I want this corner to crisscross right at the center there. Down with the big X, like that. So now we have all of our black filled in. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to start mixing a little bit of a gray. The black is going to go a long way, so we don't need to use a ton of black. We're going to need to use more white than black. And I've got a few spots to fill in here, so I want to make sure that I mix enough. So that I don't have to keep trying to remix and match. And again, just like with the black, it's going to be important that we thin this down just a little bit so that it makes it a little bit easier to work with. And again, I shouldn't be able to see it drip off my brush, but I want it to be able to glide really nicely. I'm gonna rinse this out so it's not too full. I'm gonna make sure it's nice and dry so no sneaky drips come out. And then I'm gonna roll into that gray paint. I'm gonna come right up to the top and I'm gonna put a couple X's right in here. And again, as they come down further, you want them to get bigger. So they lined up right with the other ones. Oh, you know what? I forgot little highlights here. So remember these lines that we left here? I'm gonna make a V. So we're gonna go this angle right here, this corner. And then we're going to bounce back up like that. So we've got a V. And the same thing on this side. It's going to go corner to corner on that angle. And then, now we've got those X's, we're going to go ahead and we're going to do a corner right there. And a corner right here. Dip back in. And we're gonna go with these bars, but they're gonna be gray this time. So again, we're still trying to keep them spaced equally apart. And straight up and down, the same amount of pressure on them. And then underneath that, we are gonna go ahead and we are gonna try and put two X's in this box, which means we're going to try and put two X's in this box, and then we're going to put three X's in the center box. We're going to try and keep them all about the same size. Then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to come down here, and in these rectangles right here, we're going to go right at the top and we're just going to make a dash at the top of those boxes. Barely pressing down, just a quick put down and lift up all the way across there. And then in this area, we're going to cut this right in half. So this black line that's cutting straight across, we want it to continue, but in gray. And go as straight as possible. Just like that. And again, just like we did in here with those straight lines coming down, we're going to go ahead, we're going to try and equally space them and try and keep them as much straight up and down as we can to get nice vertical lines. And then again, inside each box, we're going to go corner to corner with our X. Even as we get to these last spaces, we want to get that little areas filled in too. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to make another X right on top of this other black X. So you can still see the black. You got a little more in there. And then I'm going to come around here and I'm going to give these guys a little outline so that I can come back in here with my bigger brush and fill this in a little bit easier. So I'm going to go ahead and keep outlining this in. Now, if your space is bigger, go ahead and get in there with your bigger brush, but my space isn't that big and I'm kind of nervous that if I go in with my bigger brush, I'm gonna nick something that I don't wanna nick. So I'm just gonna take a little extra time here, get that filled in. I'm gonna take my medium brush for this part right here. I should be able to fill that in pretty easily. I'm going to just go ahead and take my time, move slowly, make sure that I'm angling that brush just the way that I need to. Just gonna pull it down. Just like that. So we've got all of the gray done. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through with just a couple of white highlights just to kind of accent things a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna use that smallest brush again. I'm gonna roll it right into my white. That has gray in it, so I'm gonna make sure I rinse out that brush really, really good. And try again, which much better. Because I want this to be a bright white. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna give it little highlights, and you can kind of decide where you want to. But I'm gonna go ahead and go right up at the top here. I'm gonna go right across the top. I'm gonna try and keep that line nice and steady and straight. Now I'm going to highlight a couple of the parts on the X's, but I'm going to just barely touch it. And so some is going to have more than others. I just want to give it just little highlights here and there just to change it up. You don't have to touch every spot by any means. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm actually going to put a line coming down right here. I'm even going to go right on top of this B just a little bit. Oops, now that. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to wipe some of that away. And if I wipe it too much, I'm going to smear it. So I'm actually going to let that dry and I'll come back to that and I'll fix that. Right now I'm going to go back into my white. I've got a drip on my brush, so I want to make sure that I get that nice and dry. I'm going to dip back into my white now. So I want to press down really carefully because I really don't want that big of spots. Again, it doesn't have to be on every single spot here. We just want a couple things highlighted. And then what we'll do is we'll come across, and I'm going to come right down this edge here. Just like that. And then I'm going to come across and around like that. I'm going to do another one right about here. And then I'm going to go ahead and kind of highlight this bar right here. Do a couple more X's. Curves on here. Like that. And one more right down here. I think that's good. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fix that one spot. So that's dry. I'm going to go back into my gray, and I'm just going to thin that white back down. So you can tell that it's dry because it's not mixing anything. And now I've got that highlighted again. So now you want to look at it. You kind of want to check it all out. You want to decide if there's any more highlights that you want to do or any lines that you kind of want to change and fix. And otherwise, you're good to go. You want to go ahead and clean out those brushes, make sure they're ready for next time.